Practice workshop guitar. Today I picked up the guitar and I did not know what to practice with you today. The beginners, the guitar students, and all of a sudden I started playing C pentatonic scales and E minor pentatonic scale, C major pentatonic scale and A minor pentatonic scale. And the major, you know what I do when I practice, pentatonic scales, you know, I practice in shapes and positions. You know, it may sound easy when you talk about pentatonic scales because you're talking about playing five notes, so that must be easy. I think there's more to just knowing the pentatonic scales and play them, but there's more to that because you need to know how to play them, in what context that you need to play them, and then also it would be boring to just playing five notes all the times in whatever music you're playing. Can you imagine just playing C major pentatonic scale throughout an entire song? That would be a little boring. So when you're playing whatever pentatonic scales you're using, you have to remember those pentatonic scales, they come from some parent scales. For example, if you take a C major pentatonic scale, those are five notes. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Well, those notes came from the C major scale. So if you're playing C major pentatonic scale, you know, in a song, so you can go and play some other notes from the C major scale, so you can add you know, some variations in to your playing. Because if you C D E G A C major pentatonic scale, and your sound, your music will sound a little bit boring. You need to mix them up with other notes. You can borrow some notes from the C major scale, which is actually those notes are diatonic to the C major scale, anyway, and then you can borrow, you know, non-diatonic notes from other scale to bring them into your playing, and then that will make your music sound more contemporary, more pleasing to your audience. So the way I practice pentatonic scale is by shapes and positions. For example, if I'm playing C major pentatonic scale, I use this shape. The first, okay, that's one shape. Okay, so you have five notes in a pentatonic scale. So for each note, you can have a position, okay, and a shape related to each position, Okay, for each note in the scale, you have a position, and for each note yours in the pentatonic scale, you can also have a shape. For example, if I'm playing, I can use this shape. Okay, starting on the C note, that's the root, third fret. Okay, and then that's my root. So I'm gonna play C, E, no C, D, C, D, E, G, A. And then this is and I'm gonna start the same scale using the C octave, so I can play the C pentatonic scale, the C major pentatonic scale in octave. So this is, sorry, that's bad. Okay, let me do it again. Okay, that's C major pentatonic scale using this shape. I don't know if you can see it. We start on the root. Okay, got to remember, you can try. I don't really encourage beginners to memorize anything in music, but those shapes, if you can memorize them, that would help you out. So this is it right here, if you can see it. Okay, C. Shape, you can move this shape up and down the neck of the guitar to play different pentatonic scale. I can move it right here. Okay, from C, this is C, go to D, so I can play the same shape. Keep going up, keep going up. That's why we need to practice. Okay, we make mistakes and then we correct them. Okay, we learn from our mistakes. Okay, so okay, now that's one shape. Okay, and this shape, you know what I'm gonna call this shape I just played, up and down the neck. I'm going to call it, I'm gonna give it a name according to the highest note in the shape. Okay, let's find the highest note. Okay, let's play it again. C, D, E, G, A, and then we got C again in octave. C, D, okay, E, G, A. Okay, A is the highest note in this shape. So, and I'm playing C major pentatonic scale. So in the C major scale, the note A is the sixth note number six. So for this reason, I call this pentatonic scale. And even in the pentatonic scale, when you play 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. So six is A. So that's the highest note in my shape. So I'm gonna call this shape position of six. Okay, for any major pentatonic scale that you play on the fretboard. Okay, because A, the sixth note in the C major scale, because A is the sixth note in the C major scale. So this shape is, position of six for any major pentatonic scale. Okay, all up and down the neck. And then you can, one of the advantages to use shapes to play those pentatonic scale is that when the bottom section of a scale becomes the top section of the next position, of the next shape you're gonna play on the next position. Okay? So it's just like a puzzle. It's just like a puzzle, okay? Like, okay, this is just like I just play, okay? C major pentatonic scale. So, okay, this is A. So right here, I just play those notes in the fifth fret, okay, those notes. To play the C major pentatonic scale position of six. So all the notes, okay, in the fifth fret part of the next pentatonic scale I am going to play. That will be another shape though. But those notes become the parts of the next shape I'm going to play anyway, you know? So it's just like a puzzle. So when you're playing whatever pentatonic scale, you can slide easily from one shape to another shape because they are connected like in a puzzle. Okay? So I give you an example. So this is the highest note, okay? In the shape I just showed you, right? Six, right? So when you reach the note six, A in the C major pentatonic scale, that's the last note. Now you're going to start a new shape. Okay, you're playing the same C major pentatonic scale. So now, after you play the last note, that means you're going to start over, right? If you're going to start over, you're going to start with C because C is the root. So what I do when I play the last note, which is A, position of six, I play the note that is three half steps above the last note, because between six and the root, there are three half steps. So this is A, my three half steps take me to the root C. So now I'm gonna play a new shape now, okay? So if I'm C, now I'm in C, right? C is going to be the highest note in my new shape I'm gonna play. So it's very easy to say that now I'm gonna play C major pentatonic scale in the root position because C, the root, is the highest note in my next shape I'm gonna play. And remember, my next shape I'm gonna use the notes from the bottom part of the shape in position six, okay, the notes, because I told you those shapes, they're just like a puzzle. One or root position, okay? So here it is. Okay, remember, it's easy because now I'm gonna I'm gonna play all the notes I played before in position of six. So okay, so I'm this. So here it is. Okay. Okay, this position here is the root position for major pentatonic scale. So if I'm playing, in C major pentatonic scale in using a position of six, then I can slide position of one, okay, next it. I don't know about that bend I just did. Okay. I'm still, now I'm playing in position of root position, but I can slide back to position, to the position of six. Okay. Position of six. So you can slide, back and forth. Okay. Okay. Two more things I want to, well, now we, that's two. Remember, for each note in the scale, you got five notes, you can have a position. Now we just covered two of them, position of six and position of, and root position, position of one. But now remember, there are other positions that we will, I will talk about another time. So now, but one thing I want you to know, that when you're playing one shape, playing any major pentatonic scale, the same shape is also, you can use the same shape to use the relative minor pentatonic scale of that major scale. All you need to do from the root of the major pentatonic scale, you move down three half steps, which is a minor third, and that will be the root of your major relative minor pentatonic scale. Of your minor pentatonic scale. This is C major pentatonic scale. Now all you need to do to play the relative A minor pentatonic scale, relative to the C major pentatonic scale is to play a minor third below the root C, which gives you A. Then you just, now you got a new root now. Minor, A minor pentatonic scale. Okay? The same thing for any shape you play, okay? One, A minor third, three half steps below the root of the major, any major pentatonic scale, you get your relative minor pentatonic scale. That means for each note you have, let me rephrase that. For one shape, you actually have, it's two shapes in one. That's what I'm trying to convey to you. If you play a C major pentatonic scale, and you want to play the relative minor pentatonic scale to that major pentatonic scale, whether it's C or another one, you don't have to change the shape. It is the same shape. All you need to do is move three half steps, a minor third, below the root of your major pentatonic scale, and then you have your your mind has put out on the scale. But now, when you use mind has put out on the scale, the position is going to change. Okay? Now, since we have, in the case of A minor, which was position of 6 when you played C major pentatonic scale, now we're playing A minor pentatonic scale using the same shape that we used for C major pentatonic scale, position of 6. The highest note for the highest note for A minor pentatonic scale using the same shape is A. Okay, and we're playing A minor pentatonic scale. So now we're playing A minor pentatonic scale, A minor pentatonic scale, position of 1 or root position. So what I do myself, okay, I say, okay, one shape, C major pentatonic scale, position of 6. Okay, now I want to play, using the same shape, I want to play the relative minor A minor pentatonic scale. So what is the position now? So what I do, if I'm playing C major pentatonic scale, which is 6, position of 6, I add 2 to 6, give me 8. So that means now I'm also playing A minor pentatonic scale, position of 8, which is actually 1 in octave. So this particular shape I just showed you, that means you can say, okay, you're playing in position 6 slash root or 6 slash 1. That means major pentatonic scale position of 6 and minor, the same shape, A minor pentatonic scale or minor pentatonic scale position of 1 or root position. So that's so it's not just knowing your pentatonic scale. You have if you play them using shapes and positions, then you won't have to struggle to find those scales on the fretboard. You know, you would be able to change from one to the other one to the other one, because they are connected just like in a puzzle. Also, the last thing I want to mention now is, from those shapes, you can also build chord structure. For example, if you play a minor pentatonic scale, okay, which is, okay, that again. And then you can play using all the notes that you played on the fifth fret to play that scale. Okay, you just bar all of them. From that shape, you just built a chord. Okay, so you can even add tension to that chord. You know, from the bottom part of the shape, you can also build a chord. See, all those chords are built from the shapes. Okay? And here's another one, which is pretty very, very interesting chord. It's movable, and this chord this one here is C dominant 9 flat 5. C dominant 9 flat 5. And if you move it up one, if you move it up one fret, which is a minor second, so that will give you D flat dominant 9, flat 5, and so on and so on. Okay. So from those shapes, you also can build chord structures. And most of the time, the names of those chords, they're going to be some sort of minor 11 chords, stuff like that. Yeah, minor 11 chords, most of them, just like this one here. Those are minor 11 chords. You can also build a chord like 6-9. See, let's C major 6-9, for example, using the shapes, you know, the notes that you played to in the shapes to play the pentatonic scales. Let me see this C major pentatonic. From the C major pentatonic scale, you can play C6-9. It's movable. You can play D minor. You can play let's see, C minor 11, for example. Minor 7 flat 5. Yeah, why not? Something like yeah, so it's not just playing the pentatonic notes. You have to make them sound interesting by combinations of other musical element. You know, if I'm using the C major pentatonic scale, I know for sure I'm gonna try to use that's the C Ionian mode. You know, I'm gonna play that. Oh, I can play some other modes. Okay. That's a D Dogian mode. So make your music interesting. Okay? Alright, maybe next time we will see some more positions. Yeah, like I said, I didn't know I was going to cover the subject. It just came to me as I picked up the guitar. So until then, have a good day and be safe. All right.